have taken a new direction, which is to look at plant genomics, especially the plant genomics that we have is of medicinal relevance. And out of this, we chose Tulsi as our plant of choice. Why? Because the Tulsi is the queen of herbs. We have a Rama subtype and then we have a Krishna subtype. In fact, whereas the DNA sequencing is done for the Krishna subtype, we have closely compared the expression of the genes between the Rama and the Krishna subtype. Not only the expression of genes, but which metabolites are there in more. And we find that the Rama has many more, higher number of metabolites. And it turns out that the Rama subtype has the highest extent of the medicinally relevant metabolites that we have chased upon. Rama is to refer to a lighter shade of Tulsi, because if you see, the leaves of the Rama subtype are light green. Whereas if you take the Krishna subtype, they have a dark purple coloration. Metabolite is nothing but small molecule. It could be a terpene or a flavonoid sort of molecule, which are tremendously complex chemically, because they have a lot of chiral centers, as it were. So it is impossible almost to imagine that in factories we can synthesize them. But in nature, by plants like Tulsi, they magically produce them in a very accurate and with a very high yield as well. We could provide now a first step towards a scientific basis about what sort of genes are required for the synthesis of the chemicals that render Tulsi its strong medicinal value.
Since last few years, there has been concern within the scientific community as well as the general public that antibiotics have stopped working at all, because all the bad bacteria have got resistant to them. So we could, from this genome sequencing project, from the results we could utilize these metabolites or these chemicals that has got antimicrobial properties, and we could use these chemicals to develop next generation of antibiotics that could fight these bacteria better.
What we need to do is to address certain situations much before they happen, right? So if we consume max 3 to 6 of Tulsi leaves every day, I'm very confident that it can prevent diseases much before they happen to people.